In the Victorian era, women were expected to dress modestly. They usually wore long dresses with full coverage. They also had gloves, big hats, and long hair. Their long hair was almost always put up and hidden under a hat. The women's goal was to look like a porcelain doll. After the First World War, women began to rebel against the way society viewed them and started dressing and acting differently. They called themselves flappers. By 1926, flappers were everywhere. They had taken over fashion of that time with short dresses, bobbed hair, long necklaces, big coats, and high heels. Flappers also had a new set of morals and values. Instead of being prim and proper, they smoked cigarettes, drank potent alcohol, and treated sex like a regular activity. When it was winter, big, heavy coats were popular because the materials that were used to manufacture them were not in as much of a shortage. A new style of stockings were brought in. No longer were they skin-colored, but geometric patterns were introduced, along with ever-popular fishnet. Fishnet was also used as a veil attached to hats to cover the face. Flappers are looked at today as one of the biggest roles that took place in changing the way culture regards women. They were what got the ball rolling on what led to a woman's status of today.
During World War II, the style did not go back to longer hemlines because, once again, cloth had to be rationed in order for the army to use. Dresses were cut to knee or mid-calf length, had collars and belts. When the majority of the men went off to war, women were forced to take over the positions they had left behind. Due to the shortage of materials that were used to create hair products, women did the best they could to look presentable. Their efforts included hats that had fish netting covering the face, gloves, scarves, and other accessories. Shoes were typically high heels of about 2 inches, and their jewelry involved pearl earrings and necklace. Hair had many different styles. If it was long, women styled it to be wavy layers with lots of body. When women wore it short, it was considered patriotic and supported the troops in World War II by calling it the Victory Cut.
Although there is not an outfit shown for each decade, it is just an example of what happened after both world wars. Super short attire was reintroduced from the flapper period, bright colors were brought in, and pastels declined in popularity. Hairstyles went for tremendous volume, and makeup was more popular than ever. Some clothing from these decades are remembered and featured in modern day fashion, despite the resistance from your parents.
Now, in modern day, we have exaggerated everything that was changed back in war times. We went from knee-length skirts being risque to showing almost our whole thigh. But fashion designers have also taken inspiration from older times to create new looks with a pinch of history. This pinch includes bringing back the mid-calf or knee-length hemlines, or just the cut of the dress. We are currently at war, but we don't have to ration our cloth, and women have been going to work regularly for a long time. Women are now allowed into the army, too, so in some households, it is the husbands that have to pick up the slack when it is their wives that go up to war. Our current day style reflects the changes that have happened in fashion over time, but with a twist. Casual clothing includes short shorts, low-cut shirts, tank tops, and flip-flops. Formal wear goes from long gowns to mini dresses, and despite how uncomfortable it is, we have raised the heels to extreme heights. Our society's clothing has been greatly affected by the 1920s fashion.
Thank you. It's not that unusual when everything is beautiful. It's just another ordinary miracle today. The sky knows when it's time to snow. Don't need to teach a seed to grow. It's just another ordinary miracle today. Life is like a gift, they say, wrapped up for you every day. Open up and find a way to give some of your own. Isn't it remarkable? Like every time a raindrop falls, it's just another ordinary miracle today. Birds in winter have their flame, but always make it all.